just goofy. They goofy. You can't really ban goofy, just let it be goofy.
We really need to get down to the bottom of what really happened. How can we make our children safe? Because we're sending our kids 8 hours into school and they're not safe.
That is the sound of a beating caught on video in the boys' bathroom at the Bluford Drew Jemison STEM Academy West in West Baltimore. This took place earlier this week. You also heard from the alleged victim, and you heard from Dondrina, a mother of another student at this school. It is another example of violence in Baltimore City schools, and the statement from the school system says yesterday, this was issued Thursday, so it was Wednesday, a student was assaulted by several other students of Bluford Drew Jemison STEM Academy West. Students involved in the incident are being identified. Appropriate action will be taken in accordance with the city school's code of conduct and the law, and then counselors are being provided. C4, you're bothered by all
tremendously
this.
Bothered because that statement gives no confidence to anybody who's been watching the reaction to Baltimore City Public Schools to incidences of cafeteria workers' arms being broken, and then a student 2 weeks later being put into the school, to a student who punched a Douglas High School cancer recovering a
That's
woman
right.
30-some years
from earlier
and then
this year.
Put right back in the school. So when you look at how the school system has responded to incidences of violence, Robert, this 14-year-old that is in the bathroom and alleged to be beating up, we've seen the video, there's no confidence that the school system is going to appropriately deal with what looks like, Robert, to be a group of young men. This is an all-male school, middle school and high school, and it was about 15 to 20 of these young men in the bathroom.
One of them is wearing a bandana, which implies gang membership.
And that's what the mother said. That's what
the mother said,
said.
Yeah, and Dondrina said that's. So, what's your advice to parents like Dondrina?
This is a criminal justice. This is beyond a school system issue, Robert. The Baltimore City Police Department and others need to be in that school to find out if there is a gang problem inside of the school. Schools can't handle these criminal justice issues because this appeared not to be the first time that this group has done this. When you see the way, take off your glasses, put them on the ground. They did it systematically in the way they beat up this 14-year-old. So, I believe this school has an entrenched problem that needs to be dealt with.
This is not the first school to have this in Baltimore City or even elsewhere, and school systems in a situation like this, they have to be measured in what they say. There are legalities involved.
Of course
they're
there
dealing with juveniles.
But you're also dealing with crimes. What we saw in that video is an assault. That is not just some type of suspension. You have this young man being punched and kicked repeatedly in that bathroom. So it rises above just two kids fighting. Well, you saw that growing up. You have two kids getting in a fight. That's different. He doesn't throw one, but he just stands there and gets pummeled.
What do you make of the student's statement saying they're just being goofy?
You know, well, the student, I believe, if you just look, if this is, there are a lot of ifs in this.
Yeah.
If this is gang related, I believe the student is trying to protect himself from further retaliation. Because if he comes out and says what actually happened, it could result in him being beaten mercilessly again. So him saying it's just kids acting goofy, it tries to remove him from a potential future beating.
This is a subject that will not go away. The
it's C4 terrible.
Show is back Monday, 9 to 1
Thank
on WBAL,
Robert.
News Radio 1090 and FM 101.5.